lines, as well as coming as it does at a key moment of the season, at the end of the spring classics and just before the start of the tours. The race can be split into two parts. The first half rather quiet, but still dotted with a good few climbs that are not always catalogued. Then, once we pass Bastogne to turn back north, things get serious with the Mur Saint-Roch at Ufalise, with its narrow road and 18% slope, and the renowned succession of one, stucco, haute-levé and vacay climbs that sees numbers gradually being worn down as the peloton sheds right off the back. The peloton then enjoys a quieter period, but less than 40 kilometers from the finish lies the Côte de la Redoute, an ideal platform for an outsider to launch an attack. But the favourites prefer to bide their time until the Roche au Faucon or the Côte de Saint-Nicolas, located closer to the finish and both with enticing slopes. Finally, there are still several pretenders in the last kilometres of the race. The short climb in Arc offers an ultimate opportunity to land a killer blow. Not difficult in absolute terms, but after 256 kilometres in the saddle and nearly 4,000 metres of vertical gain, short doesn't have the same meaning. Demar is off. Demar is off.
Several riders are attempting to break away. He's going to take them on by himself. Several riders are attempting to break away. He's going to take them on by himself. Several riders are attempting to break away. He's going to take them on by himself. Several riders are attempting to break away. He's going to take them on by himself.
The riders are going through a very tough portion with percentages above 10%. We're now at the halfway stage. It's a good time to take some food. There are reports of several riders in difficulty. There are reports of several riders in difficulty. We're starting the last third of the race. The riders are in a portion above 10%. You see that? You can read the pain on the faces at the back of the peloton. There's a growing number of riders left behind. overall in the pack. A leader is down. The team plans could well be turned upside down. It's in such percentages that the strongest can create some gaps.
Pierre Roland goes onto the attack.
Looks like a few riders at the back are beginning to stall. Looks like a few riders at the back are beginning to stall. The riders are about to start the redoute climb with its dreadful section at 20%. This climb is feared by many riders. The percentages are very high.
Acceleration by Roland. Acceleration by Roland. Attack by Basso. Attack by Basso.
This climb features some dreadful percentages. This climb features some dreadful percentages. The finish line is getting close. The riders have just passed the 15 kilometers road sign. The finish line is getting close. The riders have just passed the 15 kilometers road sign. Another attack! This time it could go all the way! 10 kilometers to the finish line. Another attack! This time it could go all the way! 10 kilometers to the finish line. The riders are in a portion above 10%. The riders are in a portion above 10%. 5 kilometers to the finish line. There we go. The sprint is on. The riders are setting themselves up.
Victory for Domenico Pozzovivo.
There we go. The sprint is on. The riders are setting themselves up.
Victory for Domenico Pozzovivo.
There we go. The sprint is on. The riders are setting themselves up.
Victory for Domenico Pozzovivo.
There we go. The sprint is on. The riders are setting themselves up.
Victory for Domenico Pozzovivo.